We're just pausing for a couple of minutes while people gather. Welcome to all of you. Make yourselves comfortable. Get yourselves a drink if you'd like one, and we'll be starting in just a couple of minutes. Just another minute until we begin. We're just pausing while everyone gathers. Make yourselves at home, and we'll be starting the service very soon. Morning, everybody. Good morning from the dog. He likes to join in. Happy Mother's Day and happy Mothering Sunday. Mothering Sunday is the official name. Mother's Day is what a lot of us know as. Happy both of them to all of you. Poor Thea is just going to go and remove the dog again. Or are you going to come and sit quietly? He likes to join in with our services, and sometimes he's learned to be nice and quiet and sit. And sometimes it just gets a little bit much when he hears the cat or sees something exciting through the window, and there's obviously someone walking past in the garden or a cat being noisy this morning. We'll see how he gets on. He might end up going in the other room. Just to reassure you, if we do put him out, he's fine. He has a really lovely big cushion to sit on and a big window to look out of and bark away to his heart's content for the few minutes until he comes back in. Hope you're all keeping well. The weather's been pretty grotty in the last week. It's still pretty windy here. The daffodils are trying to come out in our garden, haven't quite made it yet, but I'm sure as soon as it gets a little bit warmer, they'll all be there as soon as they're ready to bloom. Hope that you're all keeping well and staying safe. We are now allowed to have a coffee with someone outdoors. Woo! This is actually quite exciting after quite a few weeks of lockdown, not very much, so enjoy those if you can. And we're hoping that in a couple of weeks' time, things will be relaxed a little bit more so that we can start meeting, if the weather allows, in gardens again, which will be another improvement and another thing to look forward to as we move ahead. I'll just see how we're doing. People are all arriving. Good morning, everyone. I can see a few people saying good morning to Taffy, and I'm sure that he would say hello back in his own elegant way. Our service today for Mother's Day, Mothering Sunday, is themed around mothers and around those who've mothered us, but more than that as well, it's about thinking about families in general. What is a family? What makes a family? And also thinking about what makes a home as well. So we'll be thinking about that a little bit later on in our service. Hope you're all sitting comfortably, got yourselves a drink, and we're going to make a start with our service. And we're going to begin with a few words of greeting. In the name of the Father, and of the Son, and of the Holy Spirit. Amen. Grace, mercy, and peace from God our Father and the Lord Jesus Christ be always with you.
And also with you.
Thanks. Our first hymn, I've chosen a couple of traditional hymns for Mother's Day, for Mothering Sunday, and the first one is Morning Has Broken. I can just see that we've forgotten to plug in our microphone, so we're going to do that just now. Might suddenly get slightly better sound. I didn't need that page anyway. There we are. Thanks. You might sound slightly clearer in just a moment as we prepare to sing Morning Is Broken. How's that? Any discernible change to the sound? As long as you can still hear us, that's the main thing. Morning Is Broken is always one that I wish I could play quite like Cat Stevens, but we'll do our best with the guitar. Morning has broken like the first morning. Blackbird has spoken like the first bird. Grace for the sea. For the morning, praise for them springing fresh from the world. Sweep the rains new fall, sunlit from heaven, like the first dew fall on the first grass. Praise for the sweet. Broken does remind me a little bit of singing it in school, but I do quite like it. It's very cheerful, and this sort of seems to be a fitting hymn for this time of year, thinking about spring as well. On this Mothering Sunday, it's been a year, kind of, it's been very almost exactly a year, but in terms of the part of the season that we're marking, it's been a year now since our churches were told to close at the start of the pandemic. The first Sunday that we were told to close before we went into full lockdown, just the Sunday before that, was Mothering Sunday. And I remember well the scramble to try and sort out what we were going to do for Mothering Sunday, trying to film outside with assistance from one of our tech wizards from St. Oswald's, Stuart, who made sure that the sound was working and so on. And then the following week, he wasn't allowed to be here either. It was just me and Anthea, and we've plodded on and learnt some new skills, I think it's safe to say, over the last year. So it's a strange time. We actually sang that hymn as well outside with the guitar. I did think about doing the service outside today, but the weather's not fit for it today. Far too windy. Perhaps as the weather improves, we might be able to do something soon. And you might get to hear the birds outside in our garden. They're certainly singing away at the moment, looking for some mates, looking for some nests. Might get to hear our neighbours mowing the lawn as well. Strange, isn't it, thinking how time has passed. Let's pray. God of love, passionate and strong, tender and careful, watch over us and hold us all the days of our life, through Jesus Christ our Lord. Amen. Delighted to say that our first reading today is brought to us on this Mothering Sunday by my mum, Trish, and she's going to read to us from Exodus. And mum did laugh quite a lot when I said to her, what else is Mother's Day about except for making your mum do more things? She only sighed slightly, and she's delighted to bring our reading to us today. I know that we'll make her very welcome visiting our church. Here we are, it's Trish.
Good morning, everyone.
Morning, Mum.
Today's reading is from Exodus chapter 2, verses 1 to 10, the birth of Moses. Now a man of the house of Levi married a Levite woman, and she became pregnant and gave birth to a son. When she saw that he was a fine child, she hid him for 3 months. But when she could hide him no longer, she got a papyrus basket for him and coated it with tar and pitch. Then she placed the child in it and put it among the reeds along the bank of the Nile. His sister stood at a distance to see what would happen to him. Then Pharaoh's daughter went down to the Nile to bathe, and her attendants were walking along the riverbank. She saw the basket among the reeds and sent her slave girl to get it. She opened it and saw the baby. He was crying, and she felt sorry for him. This is one of the Hebrew babies, she said. Then his sister asked Pharaoh's daughter, shall I go and get one of the Hebrew women to nurse the baby for you? Yes, go, she answered. And the girl went and got the baby's mother. Pharaoh's daughter said to her, take this baby and nurse him for me, and I will pay you. So the woman took the baby and nursed him. When the child grew older, she took him to Pharaoh's daughter, and he became her son. She named him Moses, saying, I drew him out of the water. Here ends the reading.
Thank you very much to my mum for reading that. And Thea is going to bring to us in just a moment our gospel reading, a very short gospel reading for today from John's Gospel.
Morning, everyone.
Morning.
So hear the gospel of our Lord Jesus Christ according to John. Glory to you, O Lord. Standing near the cross of Jesus were his mother and his mother's sister, Mary, the wife of Clopas, and Mary Magdalene. When Jesus saw his mother and the disciple whom he loved standing beside her, he said to his mother, woman, here is your son. Then he said to the disciple, here is your mother. And from that hour, the disciple took her into his own home. This is the gospel of the Lord. Praise to you, O Christ.
Thank you, dear. Oops. Anthony's going to laugh now at the pictures that I've chosen for today. This first picture I've placed up because I always remember growing up, Mother's Day was always about celebrating your mums, which was a great thing to do. There was a song that I used to sing at primary school, I think it was called Super Mum. And I don't remember all the words, but it was something along the lines of, "Super Mum, you're wonderful, but very underpaid," or something like that. I don't quite know how the rest of it went. And it always made me imagine that your mum would be just there in a superhero outfit when you got home. There is a bit of a culture, I think, where we expect mums, expect women to be some kind of superhero. Not always, but sometimes seem to be having to reach higher standards or perform more to be recognised than perhaps men might be performing the same role. I'm not saying this is always the case, but quite often this does seem to happen. There can be quite a disparity between different genders. And sometimes, I have to say, when you're looking for Mother's Day cards, there seems to be quite a plethora of cards out there that are just celebrating how wonderful, how gentle, how caring, how kind, how super your mum is. And these are all wonderful things to celebrate. But I think I have another interesting picture just next. And it's beautiful to celebrate motherhood in itself. But sometimes I think it would be good to have cards like this. "Thanks, Mum, for being strong. Thank you for being the strong mum that I need. Thank you for being the strong and powerful woman." We celebrate the power of women as well. And I just think sometimes it would be nice to have a little bit more of a balance around us. Mother's Day, of course, can be a very difficult day for a lot of people. It can be difficult because perhaps our mums are no longer with us. Perhaps there are mums who are grieving themselves for their own children. And there can be all kinds of reasons why Mother's Day is hard. It can be to do with the distance, not seeing each other. Perhaps relationships have broken down. Perhaps there never was a good relationship there with their mother. Perhaps people don't know their mother particularly. Mother's Day can be a time for grief. And this year that's been brought home a little bit more again. Just like last year on Mothering Sunday, where suddenly families found themselves forcibly and slightly taken by surprise, forcibly separated, made us revisit, I think, the different relationships in our lives. Families are what we make them. We have relationships through blood with different members of our family, and it's great to celebrate those relationships, but family is wider than that as well. Our families often grow as we go through life. Sometimes for us, family becomes not just blood relatives, but friends who are especially close to us. Perhaps there have been other people who've been mentors in our lives as well, who've stood by us in difficult times. Perhaps there have been people we've welcomed into our lives recently, or maybe we've kind of unofficially adopted other people into our families. Families are broader than they might look like at first on paper. And we see a hint of that in our readings today, where Moses is taken by his mum, where Pharaoh's threatening to kill all of the young babies from the Levites. And Moses' mum hides him, places him in the basket, and miraculously Pharaoh's daughter finds him and then gives him back to his own physical mother to nurse him as a nursemaid until he's a bit older. So Moses is adopted and gains a new Egyptian family while still having his Levite roots. And of course we hear that very somber, short passage from Jesus hanging on the cross, about to die, and sees his mother standing there underneath him. And he looks down to her from up on the cross and sees the disciple who he loved. It's never really spelled out who that is, but it's often assumed that that was John. And says to him, "This is your mother." He says, "Woman, here's your son. And man, here's your mother." Asking him to look after his mother, even as he is about to die. Families are more diverse than they might sometimes look on paper. And a huge important part of our family life for Christians is the church, our church family. Mothering Sunday, as well as being a day to celebrate mothers and those who've been as mothers to us, or mother figures, parent figures to us, is also about remembering the time to go back to your mother church, the time to return home, and to visit your church family there as well. And today it's good to celebrate our church families. Just like any other family, church families are often quite dysfunctional, with a few weirdos, just talking about myself, and they're not always the same points of view shared amongst the whole church family. We're quite a diverse bunch. We don't always get on, but we do try, or at least we should try. And sometimes
church families can be really beautiful places, places of welcome. And that is what I hope that you will find at St. John's and St. Oswald's. And in fact, any other church that you visit, I hope that you find a new family there that you can instantly become part of. But I say to all of us who've been going to church for maybe a while, to remember when someone who's perhaps quite new to church comes in, try and remember how you felt when you walked for the first time into church, before you felt a part of that family. Remember how that felt. Remember the sense of perhaps feeling awkward, not wondering what to do with yourself. Why are all these people standing up and sitting down? Why are they saying these things? A sense of wonder, perhaps confusion at finding yourself in a new situation with new rules that you don't understand. We need to make sure that we welcome those who are new as if they're very much our own flesh and blood. Welcome them into God's family just as he would welcome them himself. And so today we remember families in all their wonder, in all their hurt, in all their confusion. We celebrate those who have mothered us, and we stand beside those who are struggling. We celebrate those who are superheroes to us. We hold our arms socially distanced around those who are grieving. And we stand together and we say thank you. And we pray that God will help us to always be a home for those who are seeking it. Amen. For our prayers today, Anthony is going to lead us in our prayers, and I'm going to stand just off to the side. I'll just swap this microphone just off to the side and to sing in between each prayer. You'll see the words. If you want to join in, you can, or just listen and let this be part of your prayer as well. Thanks, dear.
And so let's pray. On this Mothering Sunday, as we look back and we remember an extraordinary year, we pray first of all for all families, for chosen families, for birth families, for blended families, for those that have grown in the last year and those who have found times difficult.
My peace I leave you. My peace I give you, trouble not your hearts. My peace I leave you, my peace I give you, be not afraid.
We pray too for those people who have been exploring church in the last while, in the last year. We pray that they, as Sarah says, would find a home in a place where they can feel they belong.
My peace I leave you, my peace I give you, trouble not your hearts. My peace I leave you, my peace I give you, be not afraid.
In this week where the news has been very difficult in many ways, we pray for the family and friends of Sarah Everard, for all women who are afraid on the streets, and for all those families who are missing a loved one at this time.
My peace I leave you, my peace I give you, trouble not your hearts. My peace I leave you, my peace I give you, be not afraid.
We continue to pray for those affected by COVID-19, for our health service here and for health services around the world. And we pray that as a world, we would make decisions which take us forward with compassion and care for each other.
My peace I leave you, my peace I give you. Trouble not your hearts, my peace I leave you, my peace I give you. Be not afraid.
We pray too for those people known to us who are finding life difficult at this time, for those who are ill, for those waiting for test results, those who are waiting for treatment. We pray that they would know that God is with them, even in the midst of their troubles.
My peace I leave you, my peace I give you. Trouble not your hearts, my peace I leave you, my peace I give you.
Finally, we remember those who have died. We pray for their families and friends. We remember especially those who have been bereaved recently or those who are facing a difficult anniversary.
My peace I leave you, my peace I give you. Trouble not your hearts, my peace I leave you, my peace I give you. Be not afraid.
Amen.
We're going to conclude our prayers with the Lord's Prayer. So as our Saviour taught us, so we pray. Our Father, who art in heaven, hallowed be thy name. Thy kingdom come, thy will be done on earth as it is in heaven. Give us this day our daily bread, and forgive us our trespasses, as we forgive those who trespass against us. And lead us not into temptation, but deliver us from evil. For thine is the kingdom, the power and the glory, for ever and ever. Amen. We love to share the peace during our online services. Today is no different. I'm going to share the peace. Since we're justified by faith, we have peace with God through our Lord Jesus Christ, who's given us access to his grace. Peace of the Lord be always with you.
And also with you.
Let's offer each other a sign of God's peace. We can type peace be with you on the screen. You can press a little heart picture or something similar. You can just pray it to yourself for those you know. Peace be with all of you and everyone you love. I'm going to try and press some heart pictures. I can see lots of them. That's lovely. Thank you, everyone. Peace be with everyone. While we're doing that, I'm going to mention a few things. Just rattle through a few of my notices. So first, a reminder, we have online church again next Sunday, and that's the 21st of March at 10:30. Next Sunday, Anthea is doing some teaching, so she's unfortunately not going to be here for the technology. So you're going to witness what it's like with me doing the technology as well, but we'll be fine. And I will give you some more details next week about what will be happening the following week. I'll say a bit more about that in a moment. We are having coffee after church on Zoom just this week and next week. That's the last two. Then we'll put a pause on that again for a little while. And that will be, give us a few minutes just to make a coffee, probably from about 11:15. You're welcome to join us just for half an hour or so for a chat, a bit of a laugh. We often talk quite a lot about the weather and whatever hilarity is on our minds at the time. You're all very welcome. If you'd like to join us, just drop me a message. I'll give you the Zoom code. It's gone out to most of our church, I'm pretty sure. But just let me know if you want that code. Our prayer service continues on the phone on Tuesdays, which is growing. It's going very well. It's lovely to welcome so many people. It's particularly great for those who maybe are not able to access the services on the internet very easily, although we have quite a mixture actually, people who can see both. So it's great to involve some different people. It's very simple. We just need a number to ring on the phone. It's completely free. We have a chat over the phone and then we say some prayers together. That's Tuesdays at 10 o'clock. St. John's Church is open today, 11 till 12, and Wednesday, 11 till 12. And St. Oswald's, where I've left the picture with the nice daffodils because it's very, very topical at the moment, is open today, 2 till 4, and Wednesday, 2 till 4. That's our usual pattern, Sundays and Wednesdays, 2 till 4 at St. Oswald's, and 11 till 12 at St. John's. Our Lent course is carrying on. We've got two more weeks of our Lent discussion group, which is based around Rocket Man and Elton John. It's going really well. We've talked about some really interesting things. It's surprising, actually, how you can relate Elton John to the season of Lent. So I really recommend it. It's not too late to just come along if you're curious. That's on Zoom as well. Obviously, we can't meet in person at the moment. So just let us know again if you want to come along. You are very welcome. And I can always fill you in a little bit on what's gone before. I think that's the end of my little pictures. I'm going to sing again in a moment. Just a heads up, we are preparing to reopen our churches for in-person worship again. We've not quite made a decision yet at St. John's, although we will be doing tomorrow night. And so I'll give you the news properly next Sunday. But we are looking at St. Oswald's to start reopening from Palm Sunday, which is the 28th of March. St. John's probably from then or at some point in that week. And we will be having a range of different services through that week. It begins Holy Week from Palm Sunday through to the following Sunday, which is Easter Sunday. So there'll be lots of different services happening. And our hope is that we can live stream most of them. So we can live stream some services from inside St. Oswald's with the new internet Wi-Fi technology that we have there. And we hope that we can live stream a planned almost dawn service on Easter Sunday at 7 o'clock from St. John's Churchyard. So we will not do a special separate online service on Easter Sunday, but there'll be lots of other things for you to watch. Give you details of all of that next week, and then a reminder again. But next week, our online service is at 10:30, and we will continue some kind of online service for the next several months at least. And I'm pretty sure that it's here to stay, even if it ends up in the future, perhaps not being quite as regular or in the same format as it is now, because it's been great to interact and to worship with you in new ways and to welcome people who couldn't come into our buildings and still worship together, even virtually. Don't get too hung up on all the details yet, because we'll give you more next week, like I say. So the other traditional hymn that we usually sing, just laughing, so it always makes me laugh, this one, is All Things Bright and Beautiful. Quite a few tunes to this one. But I'm afraid I've gone with the one that's probably the most popular. Perhaps the most well-known. All Things Bright and Beautiful. All things bright and beautiful, all creatures great and small, all things wise and wonderful, the Lord God made them all. Each little flower that opens, each little bird that sings, He made the glowing colours, He purple-headed mountain, the see them, and lips that we might tell. Our great is God Almighty, who has made all things well. All things bright and beautiful, all creatures great and small. Creature wise and wonderful is asleep on the sofa. Being a good boy. Can't comment on the cats that are probably doing unspeakable things upstairs. We love them all. They keep us on our toes. Thank you very much for joining us for worship this morning. It's been lovely to worship with you again, as always. And a belated welcome to Shirley, who's just rubbing it in that she was just busy chatting in the pool in lovely sunny Spain, but it's lovely to have you with us, Shirley, and it's one of the wonders of technology that we've been able to join together people from our churches and our wider families and friends and communities through technology, which all started just about a year ago from today. Something for us to think about. As we finish our worship, I'm going to pray a blessing for all of you. Christ, give you grace to grow in holiness, to deny yourselves, take up your cross and follow him. And the blessing of God Almighty, the Father, the Son and the Holy Spirit be with you and remain with you and everyone you love, near and far, now and always. Amen. So go in peace to love and serve the Lord.
In the name of Christ.
Amen. Thank you, everyone, and hopefully see you again next week.